Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our eighth contest of the evening is a professional contest fought in the flyweight division of under 57 kilos. And the first fighter to enter the octagon into the blue corner, let's hear it for Dan Monroe.
Good lad, got your box on. Good lad, open your hands for me. Open them up. Good lad. Blue corner.
And his opponent. Entering into the red corner, let's hear it for Josh Afosta.
Say goodbye to your team. Mate, listen to me. Say goodbye to your lad. Okay. Danny. Boy, you got your box on. Good lad, open your hands for me. Lovely job. Just hold your arms there for me. Straight into the red corner, boss. Good luck to him.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He hails from Basildon. He's 32 years old, stands 5'3" tall, and weighed in at 56 kilos. He's an independent fighter with a mixed martial arts record of 3 contests, 2 wins, and 1 loss. Let's hear it for Dan and No Chits. Monroe! And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. He hails from Milton Keynes. He's 20 years old, stands 5'8" tall, and weighed in at 57 kilos. He fights out of Total Dojo, and tonight is his debut in the cage. Let's hear it for Josh Afosta. This flyweight contest is fought over 3 5-minute rounds.
Okay, fire, center of the cage. Gents, you both know the rules, you both know what I expect. Protect yourselves at all times and obey my instruction at all times. If I ask you to break, I expect a good clean break. Any questions here?
No,
any questions here? Fight hard, fight fair, fight clean. Touch gloves, back to your corners.
So here we go, Ben. Flyweight action here at Fight UK 5, here at the Athena in Leicester. And what a fantastic atmosphere it is. What a great venue.
Definitely, the crowd really getting into these fights. The second one on the professional card sees Dan Monroe in the camouflage shorts against Josh Foster in the blue and white shorts. Foster coming out of the Total Dojo, so we know a lot of very good training partners for him to work with down there.
Monroe just tentatively moving, staying on his toes.
Foster looking the slightly taller fighter for me, Rob, looking to picture perfectly, come in on that with an angle on that jab, and one, two, or three, and then maybe double it up. Monroe looking to land the hooks if he can.
Monroe with some very good movement.
Both fighters, Rob, showing good footwork, good head movement. Coming in, throwing a selection of shots. There's a takedown coming in from Foster.
For me, though, I was going to say Monroe forcing Foster to be the busier on the outside. Very calm. Does a great job of defending that takedown attempt there.
Definitely. Nice kick from Foster there. Nothing really out there. Monroe did well at the hands up. It's a nice hook to the right hand.
Some nice hands being thrown, some good leather.
Real good display of footwork and head movement for this, Mirab. Very good technically for both fighters, throwing a lot of feints out there, making their opponent miss.
Good combination again, good accuracy from Monroe.
I like Monroe throwing those hooks, but he's not throwing just one or two, he's doubling them up with combinations and he's coming in over the top, which is how he'll catch his opponent.
Beautiful hook, follows with a left there. Foster really putting his back foot here, unable to break through the defence of Monroe.
For the smaller fighter that Monroe is, the less tall fighter, the less of a reach. I mean, it's Foster really, for me, Rob, is having a lot of trouble with the riddle of the range, so to speak.
That's right, whereas Monroe seems to be comfortable. He knows his own spacing. Foster with a good shot of his own there, straight down the pipe. And again from Foster, trying to lure his man in.
There's some big shots coming over the top from Monroe. Monroe, obviously, southpaw, so difficult to kind of find sparring partners, difficult to deal with, obviously. That's the old southpaw curse to talk about doing everything in reverse. A lot of fighters struggle to kind of adjust to fighting a good southpaw.
Yeah, I spot with a very good
straight right.
As I said, that it was a huge shot from Foster, and Foster looks to finish this fight.
That's a big
beautiful big strikes,
top.
But Leon Roberts looking in close, allowing the action to continue.
Monroe did really well not to get finished there, Rob, but now it looks like Foster on the top. He's got the mount position. Looks like a cut above the eye there from one of those elbows. Foster in mount, and he's got the legs grapevined, and now he'll be looking to posture up and land some strikes. Obviously, under the professional rules, Rob, elbows that we've seen could play a very, very, very big part in this.
Foster looks to pull the arm away to open up his opponent. So he can fire those short, vicious elbows. Monroe in trouble. The arm goes up straight. Foster takes it.
And there's the arm bar submission straight
away. Beautiful work. Great win for Foster. And Ben, I was just about to say, I spar with a southpaw that's a very, very good striker. Very difficult to get around, but they do have holes in their game. And Foster proved it there, winning beautifully.
Definitely, that straight right hand right down the middle was the one that rocked his opponent. Took him down to the floor. And then what I like about it, Rob, was that he used the ground and pound to set up the submission. And as soon as that arm was there, as soon as he landed those elbows, he jumped on it and locked on that technique beautifully.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, after 3 minutes and 23 seconds of the very first round, your winner, due to a tap out by an armbar from the red corner, George Afasta. But let's hear it for a very gallant runner up. Let's hear it for Dan Monroe. Ladies and gentlemen, Josh, the winner of the last fight, he's just come forward and he said he wants to say a few words. So I'll leave it with him.
Right, first of all, thanks for all you guys there. Thanks for all you guys for coming. I just want to dedicate this win to my nan who died this morning.
What Josh is trying to say is he's had some very sad news today, and his nan passed away this morning. And he's dedicated that fight to his nan who passed away this morning. Let's all give Josh a massive round of applause, yeah?